We lift you on high, oh God. Siphakamise lakho igama. For you, O God, you rule and you reign over our lives. Sithake konje ngawe baba. We lift no other name. For you have a name above all other names. That at the mention of the name Jesus, every knee shall bow. Every tongue shall confess that you are Lord. Siyakuphakamisa.
Baba,
Sigwen Zam Kulu Baba,
Sigwen. Come on, just one more time. Let's declare that again and say, you have no rival, O God. You have no equal. There is no one else in all the earth or in all the heavens that can compare to your majesty, your glory, and your honor. Come on, lift up your voice and say, you have no rival.
You have no rival.
You have no equal.
Now
Shakatambra batoko seeke temaha.
Yours is the kingdom. Yours is the glory. Yours is the name above the name. You have no rival.
You have no rival.
You have no equal.
You have no equal. Yours is the glory. Yours is the name above all names. You have no rival. You have no equal. Now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom. Yours is the glory. Yours is the name above. Shababa rekosaya katamaha. Father, we exalt you this morning. We exalt you, King of glory. Now and forever, O God. Father, we declare you reign now and forever. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain before the foundations of the earth. He who was, is, and is to come. Oh, we exalt you this morning, Father. We exalt you, mighty Jesus, Savior, Redeemer, our God, our King. We love you, Lord God. Yes, we declare you are the Rose of Sharon. To you we give our hearts. We love you, 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 we love you. Makoto prebebele remanda bazamaya. Zebabo shakataba. God Almighty. God Almighty. El Elyon, we worship you. El Shaddai, we worship you. Elohim, we worship you this morning. Makata Brahmandele Rebebe Kosaya. Mandele Rebebe Kosaya Katamaha. Mando Brebebe Kosaya Yaya Takaba. Jebrandala Rosokotomaha. Zebabamo Shekete Brebele Rebe. Rebebebe kosaya katabaha. Zeba ban shokoto brebebele re. Sheba baban sukoto. Come on, break through. Break through in your worship today. Break through, break through. Break through in your worship. Break through. Break through. Break through in your worship. Break through, break through. Break through. Break through, break through. Break through. Shambra baba bako saya katamaha. He baba baba sokoto braba lara. Shaba baba sokoto baba baha. E baba monsa katababa. Se baba monsa katamaya. Se baba monso kote ya takara. Se baba monse kete bebe. There's just a ceiling that's just above our heads. We just need to break through. Just to push with all of our heart. The Bible says you shall love the Lord God with all of your heart, with all of your might, with everything on the earth. Just for a few minutes, love him with everything. With all your strength, with your soul, with your spirit, with your heart. Love him, love him, love him. Break through in this place. Breakthrough, breakthrough, breakthrough. We are breaking through in this place. We are breaking through in this atmosphere. We are breaking through in the name of Jesus. We are breaking through in this place. Shabra baba kote teke bebebe kosaya. Sebebebebebe kosa katababaha. Makote bebebele robo kosayaka. press on. I press ahead towards the mark of the high calling. I press. I press. I press. Press on. Press on. Shabrabando toko masakata babaha. Rebebebe kosaya katamaha. So mama mama nere 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 kosaya katamaha. Hey, Baba Yanda, say Mama Mahe Baba Bon Sheke Tebralarie, say Baba Mandele Rebebe Kosiye Tekema, so yeah, to Mama Mama Mandele Rebebe Kosiya, say Mama Mandoro Lorobo Kosaya, hey, Jesus.
You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Oh, Father, receive all of my heart. My head, O God. Holy is your name, O God. We love you.
Rebasakata Brahmandele Rebebe Kosaya Rebe Toto Komaha.
Romans 1 verse 17. For in the gospel a righteousness which God ascribes is revealed, both springing from faith and leading to faith, disclosed through the way of faith that arouses to more faith, as it is written, the man who through faith is just and upright shall live, and live by faith. The only faith that we are going to be able to conquer the wars of this world is through the faith of the one who calls us. He says he is faithful. The one who calls us is faithful, and this is the only faith that we can get. This is the only faith that we can acquire. The faith the Lord doesn't want, the faith the Lord doesn't seek, is the one found in Luke 16 verse 15, where he says, but he said to them, you and Shandara, you are the ones who declare yourselves just and upright before men, but God knows your hearts. For what is exalted and highly thought among men is distasteful and abhorrent, which is an abomination in the sight of God. Our faith is not about works and deeds. Our faith is not about the flesh, saints. It is about him who calls us. He is faithful, and he is demanding that we live by faith, that we are just and upright through his faith, not the faith of the men of God. He is not going to make you faithful. He is not going to make you just. He is not going to make you upright, but it is him. Otherwise, He is going to call us stiff-necked and treat us the way he treated the Israelites in the wilderness.
Shokoto Brahmanda Basokoto Maha. Soko Brebele Romo Sakata Maha. Remanda Basakataba. I don't want to be like that man who says, surely the presence of the Lord was in this place and I did not know it. Hear the word of the Lord and connect to it this morning.
Psalms 29 from verse 1. Ascribe to the Lord, O sons of the mighty. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Give to the Lord glory due to his name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of his holiness. Oh, in holy array, the voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord is upon many waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. Yes, the Lord breaks in pieces the cedars of Lebanon. He makes them also to skip like a calf, Lebanon and Sirion like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord splits and flashes forth forked lightning. The voice of the Lord makes the wilderness tremble. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The Lord of the Lord makes the hinds bring forth their young, and his voice strips bare the forest. While in his temple, everyone is saying, glory.
Glory to the name of the Lord. Give him a round of applause. Give the Lord a round of applause. Clap your hands unto the Lord. The two words that have come this morning are as if it's Peter speaking on the day of Pentecost when he says, repent therefore, so that times of refreshing can come upon you. Repentance, refreshing. Repentance, breakthrough. Repentance, revival. Repentance, upliftment. This morning, just where you are, just lift up your voice and say, Lord, I know I have erred in whatever area, you know, wherever you have erred. But pray this morning and say, God, I desire times of refreshing. Bring times of refreshing in this place. Wherever you are, just lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Maybe some of us have been in contempt of God. We treat him like, you know, like every other thing we treat. We treat him like whatever else. Come on, we need to repent and bring our hearts to say, God, we need a new awe of you. A new fear of you, a new love for you, a new surrender to you. We repent, oh God. We repent. Maybe we have not been faithful. We have not kept our faith in you. We have not been living by faith in you. But today the Bible says that we live by faith. We live by faith unto the faithfulness that we live in Christ. Times of refreshing. Makote bremendele rebebe kosaya katamaha. Zemandala rike sokoya katamama.
Jesus. Jesus. Jesus, when you speak, you bring life, you bring light, you bring strength. You say to Peter, cast your nets to the other side. Oh, you spoke your word, and even as we hear the voice of the Lord this morning, breaks the cedars, oh God. Whatever, Lord, is hard in this place, whatever hearts are hardened this morning, thank you that they are softened by your spirit, because your word says you have taken out of us the heart of stone and given us a heart of flesh. Thank you, Holy Spirit, this morning for convicting each one of us, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for enlightening our paths. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for convicting us of sin, righteousness, and judgment. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for revealing the heart of God this morning in our lives. In the name of Jesus, as we come, Lord, and as we yield, as we surrender to you, to whom shall we go? For you are the only one with the words of life. For your words are spirit and they are life. Lord, we desire to receive that life from you as it comes in the form of your word in the name of Jesus. As your spirit quickens our mortal bodies and quickens our understanding, oh God, that will be conformed to the image of your dear Son, Jesus. Jesus. Can I hear people just declaring Jesus? Jesus. Jesus. You are the Lord of my life. Thank you, Father.
One more time, let's declare Jesus. Let's declare Jesus in this place. Let's exalt the name of Jesus. Say, Jesus! 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 Hey, Jesus! Shout that name like it's got victory for you. Jesus! Hallelujah! We want to bless the name of the Lord and thank God for what he's doing in this place. Oh, I don't want to be like that man who says, surely the presence of the Lord was here, but I did not know it. Jacob says that. But I want to be the man who says, when the presence of God was here, I took advantage of the presence of God. I met with my God. I loved my God. Amen. This morning, we just want to welcome our online family. Thank you so much for joining us today. May the Lord bless you wherever you are. Please do come into the comment section and do tell us where you are watching this from. And continue to post your amens. Continue to post your notes there. They encourage us so much. May the Lord bless you and do you well wherever you are, in Germany, in the United States, wherever you are. God bless you so much. Amen. Church, good morning. We bless you as well in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, church. We greet you in the name of Jesus. Yeah. This morning, I want to bring before you a son of the house, an amazing gentleman, a minister of the gospel, a mighty man, a bond servant. Just as Paul used to write, I'm a bond servant of Christ. And so we have a bond servant of Christ today with us, Pastor Nkosi Ncube. Hallelujah. He is not alone. He is with his back up. You don't need to know to ask who his wife is. Hallelujah. She looks good. They look so well together. Let's just give him a round of applause as Pastor Nkosi comes up.
Hallelujah. Why don't you clap your hands one more time?
Woo!
Jesus! Ngithanda ukuhlabelela ama-chorus esasiwahlabela kudala sisakhula. Awe vernacular, amen. Kule yinye i-chorus esasiyihlabela ethi, siyabonga Nkosi yamakhosi. Ah, come on, sing it with me, church.
Siyabonga Nkosi yamakhosi.
Siyabonga Nkosi yamakhosi.
Jesus,
siyabonga Nkosi yamakhosi, siyabonga.
Usisize kwaze kwaba lapha,
Kwase waba lapha Ebenezer, Ebenezer, Nkosi yamakhosi. Ebenezer,
Nkosi yabonga,
Nkosi yamakhosi. Siyabonga, siyabonga, Nkosi yamakhosi. Siyabonga,
sina siyabonga, Nkosi yamakhosi.
Siyabonga, siyabonga, Nkosi yamakhosi.
Siyabonga.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody, you need to give him thanks this morning. Somebody, you need to give him thanks this morning. He is a wonderful God. I don't know about you, but he's been wonderful in my life. I don't know about you. He's a wonderful God. That is why we sing and say, Siyabonga Nkosi yamakhosi. Our beloved, if you don't believe, the reason that you are here today, you must say thank you, Lord. Living in Zimbabwe, you must say thank you, Lord.
Look at how beautiful you look.
All of you here are beautiful. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, music team.
Hallelujah.
Siyabonga. Wow. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Whew. Jesus. I greet you all in the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. This morning, allow us to acknowledge the presence of our Father and our mom who's watching us online. Allow us again to acknowledge the presence of our lead pastor and his wife. Glory. Allow us again to acknowledge the presence of our pastors, our elders, our
deacons,
and the congregation at large. I believe you are going to be blessed this morning. You did well by coming into the house. But when you see people coming into the house of the Lord, it shows that they trust their God. And they believe their God. Allow us this morning to read the word of God. Let us open our Bibles to the book of Genesis chapter 22. Verses 15 to
18.
Then the angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time out of heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this thing and have not withheld your son, your only son, in blessing I will bless you. And in multiplying, I will multiply your descendants as the stars of the heaven and as the sand which is on the seashore. And your descendants shall possess the gate of their enemies. In your seed, all the nations of the earth shall be blessed because you have obeyed my voice." I will ask my elder to pray. I will long pray for us.
Asi Tandazene. Siyabonga yise yenkosi yethu Jesu Kristu. Nkulunkulu wamabandla. Nkulunkulu wezinsuku. Siyabonga ukuthi uyafana izolo namhlanje lakusasa awuguquki. Nangalesi sikhathi isikhathi sezwi lapho esiza khona sizise ukuthi gwaqa phambi kobuso bakho. Sengathi ungakhulumisana nathi Nkosi usithinte ngamunye ngamunye sikuzwe lokho othe ufisa ukuthi kube intando yakho ezakwenziwa ezimpilweni zethu. Sikuphilele baba, silithabathe izwi lakho siligodle, siligcine ezinhlizweni zethu ukuze singaze sakonela. Ngelihle igama lomfelo uJesu Kristu liphakame elakho igama, izibongo zonke zise kuwe. Amen.
Amen. No, I've watched some pastors preach.
Useke wabona abafundisi bechumayela.
And you know, before they preach,
uyazibe ngachumayela,
they brag about their wives.
Bayaziqhenya ngomkabo.
And you hear them saying,
ubezwe besithi,
akusukume inkosikazi bakubone.
Rise up, my wife, so that they see you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Allow me this morning.
Lingivumelela mina namhlanje.
Tuse akuphakame inkosikazi bakubone.
Ukuthi mama kamfundisi, mama kamfundisi.
Hallelujah.
Uma ngezinyawo ibandlale kubona.
Amen.
Amen.
It is because of her that you are able to stand here and minister before you.
Ngenxa yakhe bakithi umfundisi uyenelisa ukuthi ame phambi kwebandla lapha
chimayela. She continues to pray for me.
Umthandazela kokuphela.
And our children.
Labantwana.
Amen.
Amen.
Now we have entitled our message this morning.
Isihloko sentshumayelo yethu namhlanje.
Unlocking the multiplication factor.
Yeah. Phinda futhi mfundisi ngesikhiwo.
Unlocking the multiplication factor.
All right. Ukuthi ke thina sivule singene lapho kuzabandaniswa khona.
Unlocking the multiplication factor.
Ukuvula ke lapho okulesibandaniso khona.
Now
okulokukheliswa khona.
Now from the beginning.
Kusukela ke ekuqaleni.
In Genesis chapter 1.
Encwadini ka Genesis esahluko sakuqala.
Verses 1, verses 27 to 28.
Indima 27 siya ku 28.
The plan of God.
Uhlelo lukaNkulunkulu.
Was for man to multiply.
Kwakuyikuthi umuntu ande.
So the Bible says, so God created man in his own image.
Akhoke uNkulunkulu wamdala umuntu ngomfanekiso wakhe.
In the image of God created him.
Ngomfanekiso kaNkulunkulu wamdala yena.
Male and female he created them.
Owesilisa lo mama wabadala.
And God blessed them.
UNkulunkulu wasebabusisa.
And God said unto them.
UNkulunkulu wasesithi kibo.
Be fruitful.
Lina yandani.
This is a command.
Telani.
To all of us.
Ngithi sonke lapha.
Be fruitful.
Telani.
Multiply.
Lande.
And replenish the earth.
Igcwalise umhlaba.
And subdue.
Lukhulele.
And have dominion over the fish of the sea.
Ibuseke enhlanzini
esemazini. And over the fowl of the air.
Phezu kwenyoni eziphaphaya emoyeni.
And over every living thing that moveth upon the earth.
Laphezu kwayo yonke into ephilayo lapha emhlabeni.
Now the command of God from the onset.
Umlayo kaNkulunkulu kusukela
ekuqaleni. Was for you and I to multiply.
Kwakuyikuthi wena lami.
When we start something, it has to grow.
Konke konke esiqalayo kumele kukhule.
When you start a ministry, it must grow.
Ungaqala inkonzo kusamele ikhule.
When you get married, your family must grow.
Ungathatha ungachata imuli yakho kayiqhele.
That is the plan of God.
Luhlelo lukaNkulunkulu.
The gospel must multiply.
Ivangeli kumele lande.
It must be spread all over the world.
Kumele lisabalale umhlaba wonke.
This was done by God from the beginning.
Lokhu kwenziwa uNkulunkulu kusukela ekuqaleni.
So today we are going to be talking about unlocking.
Sizabe sikhuluma ke ngokubandanisa.
How then do we unlock this multiplication?
Kanti bakithi lokhu singakuvula njani?
That God is talking about.
uNkulunkulu akhuluma ngakho.
Now in essence, what is multiplication?
Kanti kuyini ukubandanisa?
Now when we look at the dictionaries,
singakhangela incazamazo.
Now to multiply is to increase in number.
Ukuqhelisa ikwandisa.
To make more numerous.
Ukwandisa ngamanani.
To add quantity to.
Ukwengezelela okuvele sekukhona.
Acts chapter 6 verses 7.
Encwadini yemsebenzi isahluko
6. And the word of God increased.
Izwi likaNkulunkulu laqhela.
And the number of the disciples multiplied.
Inani labafundi laqhela.
In Jerusalem greatly.
EJerusalem ngobunengi.
And a great company of the priests were obedient to the faith.
Priests amanengi bakholwa.
Now to multiply.
Ukwandani ukubandanisa.
Is to become greater in number.
Yikuqhela ngamanani.
Is to become numerous.
Yikuba ngamanani amanengi.
Acts chapter 12 verses 24.
Encwadini yemsebenzi sahluko 12.
But the word of God grew and multiplied.
Izwi likaNkulunkulu lakhula
laqhela. Please stay with me, we are going somewhere.
Akuthi asibambanisane indlela la.
To multiply
ukuwandanisa
is to increase in extent
ikuqhelisa ke ngobukhona
and influence
lokuthinta
and to spread
lokusabalala.
Beloved, it is an error for you and I
bathandekayo kuyikuphambanisa
not to be influential
ukuthi wena
as a ministry it is an error for us
ngebandla kuyikuphambanisa
not to be influential
ukuthi thina singaze sathinta
be it in the nation
kungaba
be it in the world.
The
command of God is for us to multiply. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 10. Now may he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food supply and multiply the seed you have sown and increase the fruits of your righteousness. Now when we preach the gospel, it is him who gives us the word. Now he who gives seed must multiply us. He who created you must multiply you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
How then do we unlock this supply? How do we unlock this multiplication? Those who came before me, they have taught throughout the month about giving, about seeding, all that stuff. So I'm just going to pass through some of these things. Now, in order for you to multiply, you must hear this church. Seeding is important, number one. As long as the earth remaineth, seed time and harvest shall remain. What is seeding? This is an amount of money or material that you give to towards a specific purpose with an expected outcome. Now when you desire to see something, or probably if you want to harvest maize, you take a maize seed, you plant it on the ground, and you believe that it will germinate, and maize will be harvested from that field. So seeding is very, very important. John chapter 12, verses 24. Most assuredly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the ground
and
dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it produces much grain. In other words, as long as your finances remain in your wallet, it will remain as
$10.
But if you seed it and believe God, He will multiply. I know you don't want to hear this, but today we are going to talk about it. I have with me here an envelope. And I've asked my ushers, where are my ushers before I go any further? My ushers, please rise on your feet. I have this envelope with me here this morning. It is written date, name, offerings, missions, partner, building. Before I go any further, ushers, please distribute these envelopes to everyone. We want to teach people to give here. Today, all of you are going to give. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you are giving, you are not doing us a favor. Neither are you doing Apostle Ken a favor. You are just delivering yourself from poverty and from lack. Most of us here are lacking because in our pockets there is a scorpion. The very moment you put your hand into your pocket, it stings you and you quickly remove it. But it leads you to poverty.
I'm
not apologetic about preaching these things. So we said, how do you mind? Have you distributed the envelopes? Because as I'm going to be unpacking some of these things, I believe God is going to minister to each and every one of us. Whether you don't have anything, when you leave this place, the Holy Spirit will minister to you. And you will bring something into the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Beloved, it's not like we want your money.
But
we work for our
money.
So when we say give, it's not like we want to eat out of you. Remember, you people, you cannot outgive God. Because silver and gold belongeth unto him. When God says give, he's mindful of your well-being. Some of us must be delivered from the spirit of stinginess. John chapter 12, verses 24. Most assuredly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the ground and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it produces much grain. May I see your envelopes, please? Everyone, an envelope with you. Today, everyone, an envelope with you. As we are ministering, be prayerful. Lord, what is it that you want me to release? Proverbs 11, verses 24 to 25. There is one who scatters, yet increases more. And there is one who withholds more than is right. But it leads to poverty. So the one who scatters harvest more. But he who withholds, poverty is their portion. This is the word of God. The generous soul will be made rich. And he who waters, will also be watered himself. Say, unlocking the multiplication effect. Say it again to your neighbor, unlocking the multiplication factor. So we've spoken about seeding. Number two, offering. Now, offering is what you give out of your free will. We are all aware about this scripture. Luke chapter 6:38. Give and it will be given to you. A good measure. Pressed down. Shaken together and running over will be put into your bosom. For with the same measure that you use, it will be measured back to you. Now, if you don't give, what will be measured back to you? Why should you be given? Because you are with the holder. You are a dead sea. The moment you receive, nothing moves out of you. People are dying around you. And you have too much. And the dead sea, it goes. It withholds everything. It's oblivious of its environment. Say, God, deliver me from being a dead sea. Now, you know, this issue of giving, it started with our father. Now, the Lord loved this world. That he gave his only begotten son. Now, if God himself had withheld Jesus, where will you and I be?
The fact that Jesus Christ was given as an ultimate sacrifice. We are here today. Praising God. Why? Because the Father gave His Son. But what are you doing yourself? You are a dead sea. Some of us are malukazana.
Some of these,
when your mother-in-law comes,
your daughters-in-law,
you hide everything in the house. It's as if your only parents are the one who are supposed to eat. And then you come and sing choruses here. Lord, bless me. Blessing you from where? When the family is starving. There is no foundation for God to bless you. You are just a dead sea. Number three, charity.
Umusa.
How do you unlock? Multiplication. Today, you see, I am a bit slow because I wanted to sing. Charity, number three. Number three, I said number one, sitting. Number two, offering. Number three, charity. Now, charity is generosity. And helpfulness. Especially towards the needy or suffering. Aid must be given to the needy. Proverbs 19:17. He who has pity on the poor lends to the Lord. And he will pay back what he has given. He who gives to the poor, he's lending unto God. And the Bible says he will pay back what he was given. Beloved, God
doesn't owe anybody.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Allow me to share this testimony. You know, there is our aunt, Aunt Kirati Lwemliswa. She used to give so much. I remember those who were in the Ministry of Helps. Soup kitchen. Every time you come, she was there. Now, Aunt Kira never lacked anything. She never used to work. She would drive every day. Pay her rentals. She never lacked anything. Then one day she came to my shop. And we were broke together with my wife. No school fees for our children. And she says to us, Mfundis, I'm hanging away.
What's the city today? I'm on your case, Pastor.
I'm hanging away, Mfundis.
I'm on your case.
I have got an orphan who needs school fees right now. And it was August. I had no school fees for my two kids. And she says to me, Mfundis, you are not serious. Don't tell me that you don't have $70 to give towards this orphan. I say, you know, my sister, I'm broke. She
said,
Mfundis, today I'm not leaving your shop until you give me $70. Then I say to my wife, just give her $70 a hand.
Can you get rid of it?
And it was not there. It was not available.
Yes, that was the last money they had.
And August, September, schools were opening. No fees for my kids. Believe you me, what happened? After we took that
$70
and paid school fees for this orphan, God ministered to a certain couple. And they came to our house and said, Mfundisi, we are visiting you. We just want to have dinner with you today. No, my wife prepared the little stuff that we had in the house. And we had dinner.
We started chatting after dinner. And then after dinner, as they were about to leave, say, man of God, we just came to bless you.
But
we just want to love you today.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You know, when we look at you, we are stars, man.
You know, you are so lovable.
And they gave me an envelope. They gave me an envelope. You know, so we waited for them to leave the house. After they had left, we said a prayer.
Immediately they left, there was a big prayer.
We then opened the envelope. Inside the envelope, there was enough school fees for two of my kids. I didn't write a letter to the headmaster to say, who is headmaster? I am sending my kids and the school fees is not enough. That $70 unlocked school fees for my kids. I thank God if she's watching today, Aunt Kira. She knows that day she delivered me from not paying school fees by releasing just
$70.
And my kids were not going to a cheap school, by the way. You know, just imagine how much money you need for two kids. But I didn't give a lot. I didn't give a car. I just gave out
$70.
Unlocking the multiplication factor. Charity can unlock the multiplication factor. When I joined Victory Fellowship, there was soup kitchen. Every week, soup kitchen. I don't know what happened in 2020. Probably this is the reason why the ceiling is not finished. Charity.
Umusa. Are we together?
Charity.
Umusa.
You unlock the multiplication factor. Number four, we cannot overemphasize the issue of tithing. You know, these people, they work together. Tithing, offering, sitting. Now, brother tithe. He's the one who is a security guard. He will be cutting your money and your wealth and your items to make sure that the thief does not devour you. Brother tithe. Now, brother offering, he opens doors for you. Brother sitting, he unlocks again certain doors for you. You know, there is a certain pastor. Let me share this testimony. I will take it slow today. From Assemblies of God. Now, he was sharing his testimony about sitting and giving. And now God has called him to build churches. Not waiting for you to give so that he can build the church. He uses his money to build the churches. So now one day God spoke to him. I want you to go to Nkai. We have a stand there. Go and assist them to build. So he drove to Nkai. Bought cement, everything. Was there for a while and they were building, busy building. After he was satisfied with what they had done, he then drove back and came to Blawai. Now, as he was driving to Esigodini somewhere there, he had a fatal accident. And his car was a write-off. He had an old van. Now he says in his testimony, I never got hit. So he was just standing beside his car. And they were busy, the police doing their job. And he says, me, I was busy praying. And saying, Lord, I've been building new churches. Now my car is finished. How do I travel from point A to B to do the work of ministry? If you are the one who has called me, God, and you've been telling me to release money towards your buildings, in 4 days you are going to bless me with a new car. I don't know where it's going to come from. That is none of my business. But you have called me, Lord, to do your work. And I need to travel. When he got to his rural home, he got a call. From the white community in Eskotini. Somewhere in mining. Some who are in farming. And they say, Pastor, we recognize the work that you do here in our community. And we heard that you were involved in an accident. And your car was a write-off. Now we have raised money. We want to buy you a brand new Toyota Hilux. Now we want you to go to Toyota today or tomorrow. Go and choose the car that you want. Now when you go to Toyota, they told him that we can only order it from Deppen. So now he chose a Legend 50, GT6 Legend 50. And they told him, don't worry about the price. We are going to take care of it. So he chose that car. And then the Toyota guys from Deppen, they phoned him and said, ah, no, that car, we have run out of it. But we have a newer version. We want to test it on you. So we are going to release it to you. A plane ticket was given to him. He went to Deppen to get a new car. Got to the board. That the duty was fully paid up. He was given his registration book. Now from an old van to a brand new Toyota Hilux, he did not pay a cent for it. I don't know about you how much you've been saving towards a new car. Because you are a dead sea. It will not come to you. Beloved, there are some people who are very good in mathematics. They do budgets. They can't give even the next person. Because when they give you, it have distracted their budget. This person has got a very good job. Well paid, but they are struggling. And then you have someone who earns $300. Who understands the multiplication factor. They don't put their faith on their material things. Neither do they put their faith on their wealth. They understand that there is someone who is above things. You see, them building a house. They drive a new car. When you get to their house, they eat nice food. But you, with your big salary, because you are stingy, nothing happens in your life. You are so mean, you are so jealous of them. You are jealous when you see them, these people earn little money. The only thing that they've understood, unlocking the multiplication effect. Are you with me? Say to your neighbor, unlocking the multiplication effect. Say it again so that they can hear it. Hallelujah. If you really want to multiply, you must be willing to sacrifice the most precious thing that you already have. Where we read in Proverbs
11:24,
it says when you withhold more than is necessary, you will tend to poverty. But when you scatter, you increase. Increase is good. But multiplication is better. When you give, you increase. But when you sacrifice, you multiply. Now, where we read in Genesis chapter 22, we meet a man called
Abraham.
This man was a master in giving. The word of God comes to him. In verse 1, he says, take now your son, your only son, whom you love, go and give him on the altar at a mountain that I will show you. Beloved, there are things that I want to show you in that scripture. Now, when God called unto
Abraham,
Abraham was available. Now, when you read from verse 1, God appeared to him and he says, here I am. In other words, he was available. Some of us, when God calls, the number you have dialed is not reachable. Now God has an intent to bless Abraham. So from verse 1 when he says Abraham, he says, here I am. Number 2, he says, take now your son, whom you love. No, beloved, this was not just a son. He was a son of promise. Prayed for many years for this son. God released the son. And this God says, take him. Go and offer him as a sacrifice. If it were you, I don't think I heard correctly. I bind you,
Satan,
in the name of Jesus. The word of God says, whatsoever we shall bind you shall be bound again in heaven. So Satan, get thee behind me.
Satan,
but Abraham heard it was God. Take now your son whom you love. Beloved, if you are to enter into the realm of multiplication, there are things that we hold dear to us that must be released. It doesn't matter how much you love it. It must be released. Take now your son, whom you love. Walk with me. We are in Genesis chapter 22. From verse 1. Now the instruction was, take him to a specific place that I will show you. He says, go to Moriah. To a place that I will show you. Sacrifice him there. Bless consideration is very important when you are sacrificing. Not all places are fertile. That is the reason why God says go to a specific mountain. Mountain Moriah was the mountain of God. It was sanctified. And God was present in that mountain. So he said, go to this specific mountain. Some of us, church, are giving but not giving. Why? Because we give anyhow. There is a specific place where you must give. You know why I'm sharing this? Is because it happened to me. Back in 2011, my uncle, who is a pastor at Assemblies of God,
uyise omncane ongumfundisi
was praying for me and my wife.
Wayemkhulekela lomkakhe.
And he comes to our house. He says, "My son,
ave sisize endlini etindodana.
I was praying for you."
Benguthandazela.
And God asked me to tell you this.
UNkulunkulu ungitshele ukuthi ngikutshele.
God is saying you are giving.
UNkulunkulu uthi uyanikela.
But not giving.
Kodwa unikele.
Praying.
Ukuthandaza.
But not praying.
Kodwa ungathandazi.
I was very angry at him.
Ngamzondela.
How can this man agade umtshova?
How can this man leave his home?
Come to my house.
Come to my azinkhaya
kwami. And tell me that I'm giving.
Azingitshela ukuthi mina ngiyanikela.
And not giving.
Kodwa kanginikele.
At that time I was giving.
Ngaleso sikhathi vele umfundisi wayenikela.
According to my standards I was giving.
Yesilinganiso sakhe wayenikela.
But I was not giving according to God.
Kodwa wayenganikeli ngendlela kaNkulunkulu.
In other words, there was a specific giving that God desired of me.
Ngenye indlela kwakukhona ukunikela okuthile uNkulunkulu ayekuloyisa
ngaphezulu. But I did not have the revelation.
Yena engelaso leso sambulelo.
It took me from 2011.
Kwamthatha ke kusukela kulomnyaka ka
2013, 2014, until 2018. At that time, I had lost everything. At some point, my house was being threatened by the bank for repossession. No job. Business not performing. I was giving but not giving. You may not understand this. But the day Aunt Kira visited me, I think I had a revelation of how God wanted me to give. I will not go further. Even the issue of praying but not praying. At that time I was fasting 30 days every month. Until I was so thin. But according to God, that was not prayer. So most of us here are fasting. Who said you should pray? Who said you should fast? You are fasting because you fear the devil. Someone has shared a dream with you and you fear the devil. You are fasting but not praying. Let me not go further on that one. We will teach it some other time. So I was saying there is a specific place. Abraham was directed to a specific place. Number four, he walked for 3 days. Now, according to science, they say if an average man who is healthy, when he's walking, just taking a walk for 3 days, he covers a distance of about
24 to 32 kilometers
a day. So now Abraham was walking for 3 days to a place of sacrifice. Now if we are to do a quick arithmetic, Abraham covered a distance of about
72 kilometers
just to go and give and sacrifice. Beloved, if you are to sacrifice, be prepared to walk the journey with God. It cost him something in terms of time, in terms of energy. And on the third day, God says, "Lift now your eyes, Abraham. That is the place that I want you to do the sacrifice." Now, before he does anything, he separated himself from the servants. He says, "Stay here. While me and the lad go yonder to give." Beloved, if you are to unlock the multiplication factor, there are some people that must be left behind. Because when you walk with them, they will not understand your vision. Imagine if God says, "Give your only car away." And you share it with your mother.
You
know, as I was praying and God impressed upon my heart that I should give a car. Unopenga iwe.
You are crazy.
Hey,
you are crazy. This thing of giving. What's wrong with you?
Now Abraham said, stay here behind.
Oh, Abraham says it is Salanda.
While me and the lad go yonder to sacrifice. At times the things that God will tell you. Even your wife may not understand. Abraham was a man of wisdom. Gogosara was never told. That I'm taking your only son to go and sacrifice him on the mountain. If Gogosara had been told, that was never going to happen. Probably you and I won't be sitting here today and declaring that Abrahamic blessings are mine. Because Gogosara would have hindered that process. So there are people that must be left behind. You take God with you. Even your most trusted lieutenants must be left behind. When you are going to offer to God. Lord, help us. The other thing. Now when Abraham was still in that chain. The son asked him, Father, behold the firewood. The knife we have. Where is the lamb for a burnt offering? Now Abraham, being Abraham, a man of faith, he declares to his son and says, son, the Lord will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering. That statement on its own was prophetic. He says the Lord will provide himself. Now when you are in a place of sacrifice, you must engage the prophetic gear. Lord, I may not understand what is happening in my mind, but I declare that as I release this seed, goodness and mercy is my portion. Abraham did not need to understand. Imagine if he had told his son Isaac that when I am
slaughtered, if Isaac had been told that you are the sacrifice,
probably the young man would have run away. But he says, son, the Lord himself will provide him. How I pray that God may release the grace dimension upon your life. Where then you stand and say, the Lord himself will provide. Lord, as I release my seed, I may not understand what is wrong with me. The arithmetic and the mathematics behind it, I don't need to understand it. But I prophesy over my life that you, O Lord, will provide for me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus, help us here. Then the other thing, when he got there,
what a figure get up.
When he got to the mountain, he had his son around him. The Bible says he prepared the altar. Some of us, we just give without preparing an altar. Abraham had to prepare an altar. Unlocking the multiplication factor requires you to prepare the altar. Beloved, when you give, it is not money, it is not material. We give tears, sorrow, and lack in the house of God. Now, when you bring your offering or your sacrifice, you must put words upon your sacrifice, because it is an
altar.
It has a voice. We are tired of people
sesidiniwe ngabantu.
Who will come and say, Mfundisi, I have given a seed.
Abazokuthi Mfundisi, mina senginikele imbewu.
How come nothing has happened in my life?
Kodwa kungana kulalo tholo wenzakala
empilweni yami. Did you prepare the altar?
Naleyo altar.
Because when you prepare the altar,
ngoba ungayilungiseleli altar.
When you are about to sacrifice the
son,
then God appears and says, now lift up your eyes, Abraham. Behold a lamb caught in a thicket. Do not sacrifice your son. Why? Because God is not impressed by human offerings. He doesn't take human offerings. So he said, lift your eyes now,
Abraham.
A lamb caught in a thicket. Give him instead of your son.
Nigela inqama endaweni yokuthi unikele indodana yakho.
Then he goes into verse 17 and 18.
Abese qhubeka kundima 17 no 18.
Now that you did not withhold your only son.
Njengoba wena ungayigodlanga indodana yakho eyo yodwa.
In blessing you.
Ekukubusiseni.
I will surely bless you.
Ngempela ngiza kubusisa.
In multiplying you.
Ekubandaniseni.
I will surely multiply you.
Ngempela ngiza kubandanisa.
Beloved, there was a sacrifice.
Bathandekayo kwakukhona umhlatshelo.
And there was a journey towards that.
Kwakulomango.
Some of us we desire microwave miracles.
Kwesinye isikhathi thina abantu sifuna into ezenzakala khona
bona. It doesn't happen under the sun.
Akwenzakali ngaphansi kwelanga.
Some of us you want to come and sit and say, Mfundisi, I want to flow in that anointing.
Abanye bethu niyabuya lizokuthi Mfundisi mina ngifuna
lokho. If you want to flow in the anointing.
Walk
with the journey.
Awuhambe umango. Hamba umango.
Are you prepared to lose a job?
Uzilungiselele na ukuthi ulahlekelwe umsebenzi
wakho. Are you prepared to lack school fees?
Uzimisele na ukuthi wena uswele imali
yesikole. Dignity gone. There is nothing like sitting into the anointing.
Akula ukuthi ukuhlanyela usahlela.
Walk the journey.
Phakathi kwagcobo.
Don't become a dead sea.
Hamba ungazowaba lulwandlo olufileyo.
While we are
praying, all you want is to connect.
Wena, what have you done?
Wena, wenzeni, what have you done? Chicha waita.
Hallelujah. I'm about to conclude.
Says, give I get up.
Unlocking the multiplication fact. I'm about to conclude.
Says, how to scribe.
Now, when we look at Jesus. How did Jesus multiply it? How did he do it? In John chapter 6, verses 8 to
13,
Jesus is feeding the multitude. Now we spoke about seeding. In order for the multitude to be fed, there was need for a seed. Now Jesus turns to Philip. And Philip says, we have a young man here. Who's got his few fishes and bread? And Jesus says, bring it here. Now, when it was brought to him, the Bible says Jesus prayed. Some of us, when we sacrifice, no prayer. So Jesus prayed. And it was multiplied. Multitudes were fed. There were even baskets full of leftovers from a few fishes, few loaves of bread, unlocking the multiplication fact. The widow of Zarephath. 1 Kings chapter 17. Verses 10 to 16. This widow fed the man of God. When the man of God asked him of a little morsel of bread, she says, this is all we've got. Once we give you, we are finished. The man of God says, go and take it.
Bring that little that you've got.
So when she continued to feed the man of God,
the
Bible tells us that there was a miraculous extension and expansion. She never ran out of things because she had given. She never ran out of anything. Now let me just give you a testimony as I close. My wife and I got married in 2007.
Umfundisi uchathe ngomnyaka ka 2007.
It was a time of bearer's checks.
Kwakuyisikhathi laphana kusese lemali leziphamaso.
We all remember bearer's checks.
Siyazikhumbula ngalezo nsuku.
Now when we got married,
lapho bechata,
we are privileged to have relatives who stay overseas. So, beloved, you know, in 2007, if someone blesses you with British pounds, you will jump and scream and do all sorts of noise. Because all we had in this nation were bearer's checks. So now after we got married, we received some British pounds. Now when we went for our honeymoon, after prayer, I just felt in my spirit we were supposed to release those pounds. And I say to my sweetheart, baby, you know what? You know when you are about to share something heavy on you, I feel the Holy Spirit is saying we must release the British pounds. And you know our life was dependent on it because in our pockets we had bearer's checks. And my wife in her wisdom, if you hate God, let's release them. So when we came back from our honeymoon, we went into our safe, took the
envelope,
prayed, took the British pounds, stuffed them into the envelope, brought it into the house of the Lord. Beloved, it was so painful. British pounds. And you earn in bearer's checks. And in our home, we have no sofa. We have no wardrobe. Nothing. We only had a TV and a bed. That's all we had. Just after giving those British pounds,
you know our old church, Josiah Tongokara, the old building,
gave those British pounds. A friend of mine phones me from South Africa. So he had just relocated to South Africa. He says, you know how we call it. Bro, I heard that you got married. So I had just bought a pair of brand new sofas from
Pelham's.
And a double bed. I've already phoned my brother in Gwabaland. Please go and pick up that stuff. Brand new sofa. And a double bed. Now when we went home with my wife and we tried to calculate, the British pounds that we had given were not even a quarter of the price of the sofa and the double bed that we had received. I still sit on those sofas today. After sacrificing the British pounds, I don't know about you today.
Asas.
But you can unlock the multiplication factor by giving the little that you have. Beloved, it's not about the amount. You may not understand the mathematics of God. God is in the habit
of visiting those who sacrifice. You know, one person who encourages me is my wife. You know, she always has new clothes. Beloved, this woman gives clothes. She gives them away. One day she took a suitcase full of new clothes. Gave them away. After doing that, somebody bought a new clothes. I don't know about you. If you hold it, won't come. But if you release it, will come. And more will come. A good measure. Pressed down. Shaken together. Men shall give back to your bosom. My last picture and I close. Hallelujah. Say to your neighbor one more time, unlocking the multiplication factor. Hallelujah. Psalm 115. Verses 12 to 15. The Lord has been mindful of us. He will bless us. He will bless the house of Israel. He will bless the house of
Aaron.
He will bless them that fear the Lord. Both small and great. Verse 14. The Lord shall increase you more and more. You and your children. You are blessed of the Lord, which made heaven and earth. The Lord is mindful of you. The Lord is mindful of us as a church. When we give, He will bless us. Bless you and I. Now Abraham was given an instruction and I close.
Abraham wapiwa ke ulumlayo.
And your descendants
inzalo yakho
shall possess the gates of their enemies.
Labo bona baza kuthabatha amasango
ezitha zabo. After he had sacrificed.
Ngemva kokubana esenikele
umhlatshelo. A promise is given.
Isithembiso siyaphiwa kuye.
Your descendants
inzalo yakho
shall possess
iza kuthabatha
the gates of your enemy of their enemies.
Amasango ezitha zabo.
Most of us are praying every time. Enemies knocking left, right, and the center. You know when you give and sacrifice, your descendants shall possess the gates of your enemies. One more last testimony. There was a time where I was in a serious warfare. And you know when you are in a warfare, at times you don't know what you are fighting. But you just get into prayer and you can feel I am fighting. After I had done that and wrestled for almost a week, the Holy Spirit says, just take an envelope, young man. Put something in an envelope. Go and give it in the house of the Lord. It was not a lot of money. But after I had given that seed, I saw some breakthroughs. And there was calm around me. Even those that wanted me dead, they became my friends. After just putting something in an envelope, what I'm sharing with you here is not fiction. This is the life that I live. Stand on your feet. Unlocking the multiplication factor. May you please lift up your envelope. Beloved, this is not fiction what we are doing here.
I sing anyone less yenzai.
Lift up your envelope.
Pams envelope yako.
I don't know what God has said to you.
Asazi ukuthi uNkulunkulu uthene kuwe.
We are not asking you to do this because we are in lack.
Asilicela ukuthi lenze lokho ngokuthi siyaswela.
We are asking you to do it because it is the word of God.
Silicela ukuthi lenze lokho ngoba kutsho izwi likaNkulunkulu.
Now in that envelope.
The envelope.
I want you to write something.
Sifuna ukuthi ubhale ulutho oluthile nje.
Now if you don't have the seed today.
Nga ungaphethe imbewu yakho kathesi.
I want you to go and pray. Please don't put this envelope in the dustbin.
Bakithi sicela liyethandaza lingazelalahle.
We are not playing games here.
Khasidlali mandlwane la.
We want your lives, my life to change.
Sifuna ukuthi impilo zabantu ziguquke la.
So I want you to make up your mind.
Sifuna ukuthi liyacabangisisa.
Build an altar around it.
Ubususenza isinqumo wakhe ialtar.
Pray over it.
Uthandaze phezu kwaleyo altar.
Bring it into the house of God.
Ubusuyiletha ke endlini yenkosi.
And see what God will do for you.
Ubone ke ukuthi uNkulunkulu uzakwenzelani.
Let us lift up our envelopes.
Asiphakamiseni ke envelope zethu.
My heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for the teaching of your word today. Holy Spirit, how I pray that you may minister to us, each and every one of us, Lord, even as we set out and make up our minds to give in the house of God. We pray that you may open the windows of heaven. Come, Lord, and touch us. Transform our lives. Some of us, Lord, when we give from a place of lack, from a place of desperation, from a place of depression. Lord, some of these seeds are tears. Remember your children, Lord, even as they give in your house. Father, we thank you for touching our lives and transforming us and changing us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
May God bless you.
Unkulunkulu alibosise.
Amen.
Siyabonga.
Hallelujah. It's a good time right now for us to give to the Lord. Amen. Peter at one point says, hey, let's build 3 tabernacles right here. He wants to take advantage and say, hey, this atmosphere that we have, let's maintain it. I think right now is a very, very good time for us to take advantage of the atmosphere and bring and come and offer. Please come through. Whatever you have. Amen. Remember, we are giving of the tithes of the Lord. We give to God what belongs to Him. It belongs to Him anyway. Hallelujah. And we cannot outgive Him, so we're going to give our tithes. We're also going to give our offerings. Let's remember, our envelope there has also got our tithes, our offerings, our building, our partner missions, and any other. You might say, on the other part, you might say, look, I want to give this as a seed, as an offering, as a seed to for this in my life. Amen. You can give it in that way. We also want to invite our online community, our online family, wherever you are across the world. It's such a great opportunity today to give to the Lord. You can give there on our bank account. It should be on your screens. It will be Victory Fellowship account, which is the NMP account. And the details are 2102461 42. That's the account number. Let me take it again. 2102461 42. That is for the Bulawayo branch. We want to give to the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Abraham says, we are going to the mountain to worship God. And what he was really going to do was to go and give.
Hallelujah. It's time to worship the Lord. Is anybody ready to worship Jesus Christ in this place in giving? Hallelujah. We want an excited church. Hallelujah. Thank God for the word of God. Come, I'm going to invite the pastors, the elders, the leaders. Let's come first and give to the Lord. And then the church, hey, I want you to come dancing as we give to the Lord. Amen. The multiplication factor. Hallelujah.
Tawuyane moyo yedu yose kuzomtenda tawuya kuzomtenda. Tawuyane mari yedu yose kuzomtenda tawuya kuzomtenda. Tawuyane mari yedu yose kuzomtenda tawuya kuzomtenda. Farira imwari wakana. Farira imwari. Yimira imwari wakana. Farira imwari. Ona tawuya tawuya. Isu tawuya kuzomutenda. Ona tawuya tawuya. Kuzomutenda tawuya kuzomutenda. Yimira imwari wakana. Farira imwari. Yimira imwari wakana. Farira imwari. Ona tawuya tawuya. Isu tawuya kuzomutenda. Isu tawuya tawuya. Isu tawuya kuzomutenda.
Come on, dance to the Lord. Give him a dance. Give a shout of victory.
Hallelujah. Shall we stretch our hands towards the offering? Father, my God, we thank you, Lord, my God, this morning, my God, as you have spoken to us so clearly. Lord, my God, we thank you that this, Lord, is a word we will take and begin to live it. And even right now, as we have come and given, my God, we thank you that, Lord God, this is not just, Lord, something that we just do, but, Lord, this is our life. And so, Father, we thank you for every hand that is given. Lord, may you bless. May you touch each life. And those that have failed, my God, may you bless them, Lord, that they may be able to come and bless in your house. Father, that they may not fail to give in the house, O God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, my God, we thank you, Lord, for these resources, that they will be put to good use for the kingdom of God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Now, if you didn't give today, if you said, look, I didn't have anything today, I want you to say, hey, I'm going to...